All right, what's going on, everyone? If you've been following my SV650 build here, you will know how just eager I have been to get my new seat and new subframe on the bikes that I can ride it. The new subframe is pretty much ready to go. I've just been waiting on my seat, and here it is. I finally got it here. I designed it in my last video out of some builder's foam, gave it to an upholstery guy, and he made this from it. So it's not like 100% consistent with my design, but I think it's pretty much close enough that I'll be able to get this thing on the bike and ride. My new subframe is just up there, so I'm gonna pull that thing down, put it on the bike, and we'll see how the whole thing looks together. Okay, so I've let this seat sit for a little bit, and I've just been riding the bike, seeing what I think about it. I like it, but the perfectionist in me wants to change it a little bit. I think it's just like a little bit too thick and sits a little bit too high back here. I want to shave a bit of this material down. I don't like kind of still how it like sits on top of the subframe. It doesn't flow with it enough. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this seat off. I'm gonna peel up the material. The material should still be okay, and I can glue it back down afterwards. But I think if I peel up this material, I can shave off a bit of the foam, give it a bit more of that shape that I want, maybe flatten it out back here a little bit, bring this curve up a little bit later, try and tweak that shape to something that I'm like happy with, and then I can just glue the material back onto the seat pan, put it back on, and it should be still pretty much the same, but exactly the shape that I wanted. I'm just like a little bit picky on that, so let's try it. Well, here goes ruining my pretty much like brand new seat. My upholstery guy obviously made this pretty good quality. This is like a pretty solid, I think called rock foam underneath. Then it's got this mesh on top and then this pink foam to give it kind of like a softer texture at the top, and also smooth it out a little bit. So obviously destroyed that pink foam. I do want to take a little bit off of here, so I'm going to try and like cut maybe around just where I'm going to try and like sand it down. All right, that's a lot better. I think this suits the shape of the bike so much more. I also threw my skid plate design on there just so that I can kind of see how that's all gonna fit together and flow. But I pretty much just shaved a little bit down and made this like much more even grade. You can see there's still some bumps in it and stuff like that. So I've got to shape this a little bit better and then obviously glue this material back on properly. But I think this will suit a lot better. So what I'm gonna do, I gotta pick up some more of this pink foam here that I just totally destroyed and taking it off because it was glued onto the original. So I'm gonna pick up some more of this. This will also make it a lot smoother underneath this material. So I'll pick up some of that. I'll sand this down a little bit better so it's like nice and smooth, put some of this on, and then hopefully be able to glue that material back on, and that should be all good. Is finally here on the bike. I'm definitely happy with the shape this has taken now. Suits the subframe, I think, a whole lot better. I didn't do the most perfect job of like doing all the material back together. I'm not an upholsterer, but I'm happy with the shape, and that's kind of like a little bit more important to me, and it's not too bad. So yeah, from now on, if I ever like am designing a seat again, I think I'm just gonna like pretty much just gonna try and like design the foam myself, get the actual motorcycle seat foam, shape it, give it to an upholstery guy, and he can do the material on top. Because trying to like convey my idea or trying to do it in like a different foam and then translating it across, it just like misses the mark a little bit. And I think with seats, you have to be very, very particular, very specific. Otherwise it can just like throw off the whole design. So yeah, as far as shape goes, I'm very happy with this shape. I might still try and play with like add some stitching lines to the material, add a little bit more complexity to break up just like a huge volume of black material. So yeah, we'll play around with that a little bit more. I also am gonna look into trying to see if I can like get these finalized and then get like multiple of these made, see if I can replicate it at all. So yeah, you can see I've also got my skid plate prototype on there. This is just a 3D printed version, but the overall shape I'm happy with, and I'm happy with the design. So I'm gonna be plasma cutting this soon, and getting that like a proper version on the bike, as well as working on a few other parts. But main thing is just getting like this subframe and seat done. Just like, I don't know, I'm so like, everything just takes so long, so much longer than I would have liked or would have expected, but we're getting there, and I will have an update on the actual final version of the subframe, production level quality, very soon. It'll be coming through very soon. So yeah, here we go though for the seat.